too tired to train today, mate. So tired, what can I do? Got it? I'm too tired to train, mate.
I don't want to know, mate. I don't want to know. No, it's, on a serious note, like, some people will come out with these kind of comments. People will try and make progress and want to talk about wanting to make progress, but then turn around and come out with comments like, I'm too tired, I can't be bothered, I'm not feeling it today. And you know what, like today's society was so soft and we're so politically correct all the time that we want to say something to enable these people and, oh well, you know, just give yourself a day off and that. Let's just stop the bullshit. If you want to get in shape, it's going to require hard work and consistency. If you don't want to work hard, and you don't want to be consistent, then I'm afraid you're not going to get the end product. You don't get wealthy or get a nice car or a big house by being a lazy bastard. So why would you create a great physique or get really fit or get really strong by being a lazy bastard?
And that's the reason why you are not in shape.
Yeah.
Because that is the excuse you'll tell yourself. I'm too tired to get out of bed. I can't get out of bed at 7 a.m, 6 a.m, 5 a.m, whatever it is. You know what I mean?
And don't moan about not having the thing that you're not willing to work for.
What's that saying?
Don't complain about the results you didn't get from the work that you didn't do.
Boom. Drop the mic. It is as simple as that though, isn't it? It really is. But how many sessions, how many sessions do you turn up buzzing to train, like ready to rip your head off? It's very rare, like, we turn up and like, oh, I'm ready for this. You're tired, you've had minimal sleep, you know, you're doing long days in the gym, your head's fried, some client peppered your head before. We've all got them excuses. The difference is, we still turn up and we elevate for that session.
Let's be honest, once you start the session, everything goes away, everything starts to happen. And any kind of problems and like pain in the ass comments you were having in your head before it disappear.
I think a big point is what you said there, it's like just get moving.
Yeah.
Like you'll know
get
when
started.
Yeah, it's like when you're deep in a diet and you're at the end and every fucking set and the rep is hard. You end up chunking the session. See that, like, right, I've got 5 exercises. I feel like shit, I'm tired, how do I get through this? Right. You look at your logbook or you look at the session, whatever approach you've got, right, just get moving first, let's get the blood flow. You start switching on, you put your music on, you've had a pre-workout, you still feel like shit, but you keep moving. Say you've got a flat dumbbell press to start with, you pick up something light, just do as many reps. And by 2 or 3 sets in, you start thinking about just the session, and you start switching on a bit. Yes, you might feel a bit tired, but before you know it, you start flying pretty quick, and you'll hear it off every client you speak to. I was dead tired at the start, and I had the best session of my life.
Think about what we used to do years ago to get up for a session, because we were doing loads of heavy sessions back to back. We used to sit in a cafe, we used to watch rugby league big hits with a massive pot of coffee, get charged up, and then absolutely rip the head off the gym. And we did that same ritual all the time before we trained. End result was 6 sessions.
It comes down to that pre-ritual routine. You have to have something to break that mindset, because tiredness is a mental game.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
You can tell yourself you're tired when you're physically, you're not really.
And the more you tell yourself you're tired, you feel more tired. So that's your brain setting yourself up for, well, I suppose weakness, really.
Yeah.
If you think positive, you become positive. You think negative, you become negative. You think you're tired, you become more tired. So what you're doing in the brain, the little story you're telling yourself, needs to change for something more uplifting. Changing the routine. For us, for example, you can see with the gym, we leave the gym to come back in the gym to train, because it breaks the monotony of coming out from session. Now, if you're coming from work, that routine of leaving work, getting in your car, slam a pre-workout down, tunes are banging, sit there buzzing, take away the stresses of the way. By the time you turn up to the gym, you're ready.
Ready to go.
Then you come in the gym's bouncing if you come to a good one. And then it takes it from there.
Sales.
So it's big. Like, anyone can use that excuse of I'm being tired. It's if you listen to that story that you tell yourself.
Sort of sale.
So, £28 a month.